Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulihi al-kareem wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tasliman kathira. Dear brothers and sisters, I'm going to try to, inshallah ta'ala, make it short. I'm not going to go longer than Maghrib, so I won't go more than 30 minutes, inshallah ta'ala. And, you know, honestly, I wanted to just kind of leave everyone with some practical tips, because I know that one of the things that usually happens is when you go to a convention, when you go to a conference, wow, that talk was mind-blowing. That was awesome. Did you hear what Brother Nu'man said? Did you hear what this speaker said? Did you hear what Brother Omar said? Did you hear what Brother Qasim said? Did you hear that? Did you hear what Dr. Arif said? But at the end of the day, we really don't make much change. There isn't really much practicality. Sometimes that's the fault of the speakers. Sometimes that's the fault of the listeners. And here's the thing. I know that this topic has probably been regurgitated hundreds of times under the guise of different titles, different khutbas, how I can change now. But you know, Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullah, he said something very powerful, because Allah azza wa jalla tells us in the Quran that those who seek huda, guidance, will be guided. Those who seek it will be guided. So essentially what Allah azza wa jalla tells us is that if you really want to change, then the first thing is that you have to want to, if you really want to change, then the first thing is that you have to recognize that there is something about you that needs to be changed. Looking at yourself, recognizing those things, as Brother Nu'man said, not blaming anyone else for anything, not looking at the world and suffering from analysis paralysis, you know, where we'll just sit around and complain and whine. And the same brother that's talking about how terrible everything is in Gaza and how terrible everything is in Pakistan and Africa is the same one who won't put forth even an hour's worth of volunteering towards his masjid or towards any Islamic cause. But I want to really focus more on the individual. I think Brother Nu'man covered very well the idea of a society, you know, how we can change as a community. But if a person is changed, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, through that person, would change many things in the community. So it starts with each and every single one of us. Here's the thing. If you want to change, Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullah, he says something beautiful. He says, إِذَا الْمَرْءُ كَانَتْ لَهُ فِكْرَةً فَفِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ لَهُ عِبْرَةً. When a person is really deeply involved in some sort of thought, when something is heavy on his mind, heavy on his heart, then everything around him will be a guide towards that thing. Let me put it to you this way. How many of you guys have met annoying newlyweds? Raise your hands. How many of you guys are annoying newlyweds? Nobody? No, I don't think so. I was about to call you out. Good call. None of you are annoying. You know the people that go around and all of a sudden you put like 1,000 pictures on your Facebook the day after your wedding? And I'm like, shouldn't you be doing something else the day after your wedding? And uploading 1,000 pictures and it's like you've got these cute little shirts that point to each other and there's thing one and thing two and I'm hers and I'm his and all that kind of stuff. And it's like people really don't care that much about your life. But anyway, the thing is that whenever you fall in love, or whenever a person gets engaged, let me tell you what happens from a guy's perspective. One day, this same guy wants to play basketball all the time, wants to always hang out, annoys his married friends because he's not understanding enough to understand that the married guy has to get home by midnight, wants to go hang out all the time and every, you know, at any time of the day. Then all of a sudden, he gets engaged and he never answers his cell phone again. Until a year later, whenever he wants to run away from his wife and he wants to hang out again, look for an excuse to hang out, right? But the point is when that person is in love, when that person is overwhelmed, when that person is overcome, when that person is really in that mood, subhanAllah, everything they look around, everything they see around them reminds them of love, right? Like, oh, that empty paper cup in the parking lot. It's so beautiful. Look how it just goes with the wind. I wish I could be that paper cup in her house and just float around and all that stuff. You know, like all that. Here's the thing. You love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything around you has meaning all of a sudden. Every single thing. You really have a sense of urgency. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show you the way to change. Because you know what? At the end of the day, it's different for everybody. All of us have our different demons. including me, including Brother Nu'man, including Brother Qasim, including Dr. Arif, including all of us. We've all got our own set of problems. And every single problem has its specific solution. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who guides you to that. But the first thing you have to have is a sense of urgency. Don't worry about anyone else. Don't worry about what other people are doing. As Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah said, "Rahimallahu imra'an shaghalathu 'uyubuhu 'an 'uyubin nas." May Allah have mercy on a person who is too busy with his own faults to be worried about anybody else's faults. A sense of urgency.